Hey, how's it going, everyone, and welcome back to another Bisect Hosting server tutorial. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to install Forge for 1.17.1 on your Bisect Hosting Minecraft server. Alright, let's go ahead and jump right into the tutorial today. The first thing we'll need to do is download Forge for 1.17. I'll leave a link in the description below for the download link. All you have to do is open up the page and then just click the installer button here to begin downloading on your personal desktop. Now, I've already gone through that process and I have it downloaded here in the bottom left-hand corner, but now we need to drag and drop it into an empty folder. So right now I have this empty folder, I just called it Forge, and I'm just gonna simply drag and drop it into that empty folder, and then just double click to launch the installer. Okay, great, so now that the installer window has appeared, all we need to do is switch some settings. So the first thing we'll do is switch this to be, instead of install client, we're gonna select install server. And you'll notice down here it'll kind of turn red, but that's okay. All we got to do to fix this problem is switch the directory to our empty folder. To do that, we're just going to select these three little dots here, and then I'm going to click on my desktop and then select that empty folder that I called Forge. Once you select it, you can just click this open button and then go ahead and click OK to begin installing all of the necessary files into that empty folder. This can take up to a few seconds to a few minutes, so just let the installer do its work. Alright, so once the installer is finished, you'll notice that in that empty folder, we now have all of those files that are needed to run a Forge server. So now we need to begin uploading this to our Bisect Hosting server file manager. To do that, I'm just going to go ahead and head over into our premium control panel. You can use the budget control panel as well. And we're going to go ahead and stop our server before we make any major changes. So I'm going to go ahead and select this stop button here, and then just simply wait for it to confirm that the server is now offline. Okay, so once the server is offline, we're gonna head over into the file manager here on the left-hand side, and then we're gonna select this green upload button. From here, it'll ask you to drag and drop some files and folders in. So I'm gonna open up that folder that has all of those files that we had just created earlier. Now I'm just gonna go ahead and highlight them all, and then just simply drag and drop them into that Dropbox. Now it all just depends on how fast your internet speed is, but it should just only take a few minutes to upload to the file manager. Okay, great. Now, once all of them are uploaded, we now just need to tell the server to use the custom 1.17 Forge install. So we're gonna go ahead and head back over into the home panel here, and then we're gonna select on Open Jar Menu. And once you select that button, you're gonna see a bunch of different options here on the left-hand side. Right now, I currently have vanilla for 1.17.1 loaded, but we just need to switch this to the custom preset. So we're gonna go over here and click Custom, and then Custom Forge for 1.17 and above. So I'm going to select that here and then go down and click save. Now it'll ask you what you want to do with your current files. I had vanilla for 1.17 already installed before I did all these steps, so I'm going to go ahead and click keep current files. But if you want to start with a completely fresh world and everything, you can go ahead and select delete current files. Alternatively, if you want to create just a whole new instance so you can save everything you had prior, you can just click the create instance button. If you're still a little confused on how this works, feel free to check out the how to manage your instances video here at the top. Okay, great, so I'm gonna go ahead and click keep current files, and Bisect Hosting will do all the necessary file movement and management for you. Okay, great, now all we need to do is click start to begin starting our server, and now you have successfully loaded Forge for 1.17 plus on your Minecraft server. That's gonna go ahead and wrap up today's video. If you have any other questions or concerns, please don't hesitate to contact us on our support tickets, or you can view our complete knowledge base at bisecthosting.com/kb. If you enjoyed today's video and would like to see more, consider giving us a thumbs up and subscribing, and comment down below what you'd like us to cover next. Thanks for watching.